G'day. Parliament will resume next week, but it will be a very different Parliament to what we're used to. The coronavirus has necessitated in many workplaces that we adapt to this new reality, and Parliament will be the same. Now, we're in the middle of a pandemic, as I'm sure you well know, and unfortunately the COVID-19 virus is active in Australia, and we know that the only way to stop the spread of the virus is to stop people moving as much as possible. That and obviously cleaning your hands and keeping that social distance. So as you're well aware, some states and territories, including Queensland, have closed their borders and imposed quarantine measures for residents when they return. Victorian MPs and senators who wish to attend Parliament in person are required to quarantine for 2 weeks before attending. For Queensland MPs and senators, it's not quite as bad. We need to quarantine for 2 weeks when we return from Canberra. I'm assuming that they'll let us back. Of course, for many MPs and senators, that is just not possible, and some won't be attending in person. Today, the government, in consultation with the President and the Speaker, have announced new rules to allow members of Parliament who cannot attend in person to contribute remotely during the next sitting, doing basically what we're doing now. We'll be allowed to make speeches remotely and to ask questions remotely. It will be quite amazing. I won't be attending Parliament for the next two sitting weeks. I'll stay right here in Moreton. I'm in Sunnybank right now, but I'll contribute remotely as much as possible. Obviously, I'll continue to represent you, my community, down in Canberra, even though I would not be there in person in Parliament House. I'll still keep you posted about what is going on in Parliament, just like I usually do, so watch this space for updates. In a little preview, in the second week, on Monday the 31st of August, my private members bill will be the subject of a short debate, so watch out for that, I'll keep you informed. That's the one dealing with domestic violence. Keep an eye out for that. Cheers.